A hard-headed woman.
That ain't why I gave her the money.
Be quiet and listen.
Has a tough time with the judge.
You're not acting grown.
So what's the difference?
You want to talk back? Bad, bad, bad.
Woo! Bad girls you love to hate. Today on Judge Joe Brown.
These sisters split up after one refuses to let her boyfriend spend the night. Hairstylist Kiana Moyer is suing her sister for unpaid rent. Defendant LaGretta Moyer says the plaintiff would not let her boyfriend stay at the house. Now it's Joe time.
Ms. Moore, you're suing your sister. Ms. Moore, apparently you two rented a place together, and there's a dispute about move out and remaining rentals and expenses and justifications for moving out. So let's see, Mrs. Kiana Moore.
Yes.
I believe you're the plaintiff, so you start first.
Well, we moved in February of 2009, and I didn't want to really do it because, you know what I'm saying, I was just stressed out dealing with a lot of things at the time. And
I think you were pregnant at the time.
Yes, sir. I was pregnant at the time, but I agreed to do it because that's my sister, and I was trying to, you know what I'm saying, save money at the same time by going in with her.
Because, times are hard.
Right. So I agreed to do it with her, whatever. And anyway, she stiffed me, you know what I'm saying, 2 months into the lease agreement, whatever. She paid her rent or whatever. She was staying with her boyfriend before that. And
he got busted on a drug charge.
Yes, sir.
And little matter of being locked up.
Correct.
But he got out.
Correct. And when he got out, you know what I'm saying, she wanted him to come stay with us, and I didn't want him to come stay with us because I don't like him. He don't have no type of income, and I got my kids there, her kids was there, and, you know what I'm saying, it wasn't big enough, you know what I'm saying?
And her baby dad
Well, I kind of got that, what you're saying. I don't know if I know what you're saying. I hear what you're saying, but I don't know it because it wasn't there, but you're telling me about it.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir, Your Honor. I didn't want him to stay there because, you know what I'm saying, because I don't like him, and I just didn't like him at all, and I still don't like him, and she...
All right, so you didn't want her boyfriend to stay there.
No.
So is that why you say she moved out?
Yeah, because she wanted him to move in, and I didn't want him to move in, and she tried to, you know, gradually take a little bit of stuff at a time out the house or whatever, try to make it seem like she was there, but she really wasn't there. Then all of a sudden, she just didn't come home.
No, so she moved out according to you. Hold your point.
I left.
You say she moved out 2 months into the lease.
Right. Like, she was, like, trying to make it seem like she was still there because she had a little bit of stuff there, but her body wasn't there. She wasn't there. You know what I'm saying? The kids was there, whatever.
Well, when did she stop paying the rent?
April. She didn't give up no money for April.
And you say that you were there. Let's see, you had a 13-year-old and 12-year-old, and you were pregnant at the time.
Yes, sir.
And I believe the defendant had a 17-year-old, two 16-year-old twins, and a 12-year-old.
Right.
So you're trying to get unpaid rentals, and you're giving her credit for some payments that she apparently made. Is
yeah.
that correct?
Yes, sir.
Well, how many payments did she make October through February?
Yeah, she was giving me money. She started giving me money in October because him and her was having little issues or whatever. And
him and her?
Her and her boyfriend was having issues because that's who she was staying with. So she started giving me money, you know what I'm saying, because she might have had to, you know what I'm saying, come back home or whatever, and I needed the money.
That ain't why I gave her the money. I was giving her the money.
Wait. Time out. I understand you have a different position on these issues.
I'm saying, she ain't telling her right.
Well, if you want to tell me your side, I suggest you wait till she gets through. Because if you keep trying to interrupt like that, you cut things off, and that takes extra time, and you may try the arbitrator's patience. Let her finish, and then you'll get the floor. Now, I've looked at your sworn accounting, and I see the lease, the payment receipts, and the promissory agreement. Now, why do we have a promissory agreement here?
Your Honor, because I kept asking her for my money. She was having money here and there, and I kept asking her when she was going to give me my money. She tried to write the promissory notes, because I was getting on her nerves about my money. So she was going to tell me that she was going to give me my money back this year when she filed her income taxes, and she ain't gave me nothing. But that's why she wrote the promissory note talking about she was going to give me my money when she got her taxes and still ain't gave me my money.
It ain't.
Well, why do you say she moved out if she was still paying partial rent?
She didn't start paying me no rent until October.
Let me explain it to you.
No, you don't yet. Wait.
Man.
Maybe that's why. Don't, man. You don't have permission to do that. I'm a lot older than you. What are you, 34?
Yeah.
All right. Now, you started off early being a mother.
Who?
You.
I was 17 on my own when I had my first child in my own place.
That's grown?
It doesn't matter. I was on my own. I wasn't
That's
staying
grown.
With my mother. It was grown enough to have my
well,
own place.
Well, maybe what
work.
The problem is the reason you had that one at 17,
and
not
then my
grown.
My twins at 18, and then my last one
Next
at 21.
Next to it when you weren't grown, and your parent, were you married?
And she ain't either, so what's the difference?
So you're okay. not grown then, and maybe what we have is a case of, what is it, arrested development, because you're not acting.
If her man can lay up in the house where I'm paying rent,
Excuse me, you're not going there right now. I'm trying
to
restore.
He was giving me money, too.
Okay.
Excuse me, both of you, you can walk out the back door with nothing resolved in a little bit if you don't stop. I'm trying to restore decorum. Now, the point is at 34, I expect you to act like you're full grown. Maybe there is arrested development because you're not acting grown in here. Now,
I'm
if already
grown.
You want to talk back, I'm not your sister.
Okay.
I suggest you listen very quietly. Don't say anything. Try and follow the instructions. Because when you can't follow the instructions I'm giving you in here, I have a suspicion that part of the problem that we're dealing with right now relative to this arbitration is because you don't listen, or if you do listen, you don't comprehend. Now,
comprehend
be quiet.
And listen.
Shut your mouth. You have to have discipline and maturity if you're going to teach it to your children. I suspect.
My kids is grown.
No,
good.
They're not.
Yeah,
they're not
good.
Grown.
Don't even
Trust
speak on
me.
My kids. You don't know my kids.
Trust
don't
me. I know you.
So
and the fruit doesn't
me.
Fall too far
well, you
from
don't
the
know
tree.
Me. You just
I know you.
You.
I can tell right
know
now. I know all
you
I need know, to know
no,
about you,
don't.
Relative to your inability to
okay,
exercise self control.
Judge, you, okay, you think you know me, but you don't know me.
Whoa, but I do.
No, you don't.
Let's see what we added up. I've had somewhere in my legal career about 85,000 individuals I've dealt with.
I mean, that's
now.
True.
Do you think if you see 85,000 people
you don't
over
know
40
me.
Years going
you,
back? And
you
forth with this, you
me?
Don't feel. Yeah,
hey,
I do.
Listen. We'll be right back with Judge Joe Brown.
He had the same job that my dude had.
Well, did he have a job?
Yeah, on the street corner, yeah.
So both of you have got boyfriends that have little hustles, I assume, moving merchandise.
Right.
Bad girls you love to hate today on Judge Joe Brown.
We're back with Judge Joe Brown. The defendant in this case insists that if her sister's man can stay at the house, so should her man. But when the plaintiff refused, she left. Let's see what the judge has to say.
Now, you have the floor right now. We're going to you. Now,
okay,
what is your problem?
March and April, I paid rent. She had a problem. She don't have the problem with my dude. Her dude got the problem with my dude.
Well, excuse me. That's not what I really am interested in right now.
Okay,
I need to find this out. Be quiet and listen.
This is where the issue comes
listen.
From.
Listen. You say that in your complaint, your man was helping you out with your kids and things. He had money. You're over here offering up. Why don't you get undefensive a little bit, uncross your arms?
I'm cool.
Well, let me put it to you this way. Stop being so defensive. Open up, be receptive. And what happens is I'm going to ask you a couple of questions.
Okay, come on.
Now, just listen. Your mouth runneth over.
Yes.
Take a breath.
Now I'm ready.
Now, she has said that her boyfriend helped her out with the bills and her children. You say he didn't have a job.
He had the same job that my dude had.
Well, did he have a job?
Yeah, on the street corner, yeah. Now, can he file taxes
that's,
on that? No, he can't.
That's not true, Your Honor.
You know, you should leave the efforts to humor to me.
Well, can he file taxes on it? No. He didn't work a 9-to-5 like we worked a 9-to-5. We was paying rent. Now, what was the problem with my dude being there if her dude was there?
You're saying her boyfriend just had a hustle. He didn't have a job.
Right.
And that's not true.
All right. Now, your boyfriend apparently had a hustle, or at least he got accused of one moving a little merchandise.
Right.
So both of you have got boyfriends that have little hustles, I assume, moving merchandise.
Right.
No.
So these kids, including one, two, three sons, three boys, are supposed to be getting role models, two unemployed males who are moving merchandise. The poison where they live.
Can I please say something?
No, you can't. So your defense, I'm reading, is that it should be basically tit for tat. Sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander. In this case, sauce for the goose is sauce for the other goose. If she can have her boyfriend spend the night, why not yours, since both of them do the same thing?
Not even about what they do. I mean,
no, it is about what they do. Be quiet and listen, because one of the issues that I have to consider is whether or not there's what they call constructive eviction, or there is such conduct or such circumstances as would demand that the circumstance that you two put yourselves into be broken up. The bottom line is did you have cause to abandon the place?
Yeah.
No.
What?
Why should I pay rent and I got to go somewhere else and pay for a hotel room to be with my man, and I'm paying rent and the house and her man laying up in the same house that we splitting the rent?
Okay, but he giving her money, though. Your man wasn't giving
her
nothing.
He's giving me money. So I don't know what her man giving her.
He paid your part of the rent.
That's after I was gone.
He paid your part of the rent,
after I was gone.
He paid your rent.
I'm had enough. Both of you out of here. This is ridiculous.
This courtroom is now in recess.
Well, to his company, the ex-con boyfriend made three a crowd for the plaintiff, but the judge felt the courtroom got too crowded with mouth. This case was dismissed.